being Lisa D. You see, my purpose is for me to speak and you to listen.
Otherwise, it's polygamy. Which we
and
do not
people think. Want to keep gays out of marriage? Let us all just listen. I'm straight and I don't want to be married. Right. Y'all go right ahead and get married. Dun, 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 and the record scratches.
But this is for their attempt to try to make us happy.
And I wanted to be a part of the festival, and I just flew in. I just got off a plane, so I knew
and
I was.
You look good, girl.
Girl, I'm working on it, honey. You know, you.
I like the color. You like my color?
Yeah, girl.
Boo hoo hoo. We're going to put a camera on you to make sure you do your job.
60.
Let me just tell you something. I worked for major corporations for 8 years of my life, and every year I got evaluated at my job, and if I didn't do a good job, I got fired.
60.
So your evaluator is the customer.
60
Who's the
people,
customer? The public.
60.
When you interviewed her, did you get a sense that this young girl was in trouble?
Absolutely not. When I interviewed her at the red carpet screening of Houston's On Our Own, the Lifetime docuseries, she was excited about the project. She was ready to start a new life.
Social media is so strong now, people will be stupid not to take advantage of it because the brand is there. And I gotta tell you, I live in Newark, New Jersey. We have a movie theater by my house. I'm renting out rooms, people. Come and stay before the film comes out. And wait a minute, I love the fact that he's down with the swirl. It must be good to be his wife. Melanie Hobson, when you get a divorce, I'll take your place.
She said down with the swirl.
My question is it normal that I want to spend the holidays with my friends and not my family?
Oh. I say hell yes, it's normal. My saying is, blood is thicker than water, but water tastes better. We know that there's always family drama during the holidays, and you know you have that crazy uncle buddy who's always prancing on the table in that tutu, and you never can tell when one of those cousins are gonna come out and say, I'm gay.
Of course they're going to backpedal and say we're going to do diversity training. That's the go-to line. Yeah. But you're on a party train. We're drinking wine. There's a group of women who are in a book club, and they're chatting and talking. Who were these people that made complaints?
Makai was so gracious to give me an interview, and he said, I have something coming out called, 2 years later it's coming out. Sorry. How was that? Like, you say something 2 years ago and it comes out. Why does it take so long?
Well, it's a lot of different reasons. You know, this particular reason that, you know, the Columbine shootings happened.
First of all, Lynn, African Americans are not so dumb to want to go to Livingston, New Jersey and take their million-dollar homes, their trust funds, their bank accounts, their 401k plans, and their cars and say, woohoo, we have reparations. Many of us have our own homes, cars, and 401k plans, and some have trust funds.
A lot of folks don't like you. Do you give a damn?
Well, you know what? It really, I don't have a chance to even think about it. I just keep trying to do what is right.
Why did you decide to accept the award this evening for the Combat Awards?
Well, Larry Hazard, everyone knows, a great friend of mine, and I was just happy to do anything to help him with his organization.
I think that if we had more good black men for us, we'd be fine. Listen, I'm very generous. If I had a whole loaf of bread, I'll give you 2 slices. If I have 2 slices, I want the sandwich for me.
Lisa, I see you nodding. Care to add?
I care to add. All day breakfast at McDonald's? I'm loving it.
Okay, what's your take?
I'm straight out of Compton. 1, 2, 3, and to the 4. I'm hip hop for life, but yes. I can't rap. Right. No, it was eerily familiar to what's happening now because when I started to see all those Rodney King, that footage, I had forgotten about it.
Lisa, you've heard her on this program, Keep It Real. That's her kind of slogan, African American pop culture commentator. So what do you think about Dr. Ben Carson and his advice that you've got to be a hero when confronted with danger like the shooter in Oregon?
Well, I think the myth, he called Obama a psychopath. I think Ben Carson's psychopath.
And it was unnecessary because she could have still been the same person in the same position.
Without saying that she was black.
Pumping her fist, marching on Washington.
Because there are plenty of people of all colors that support those causes. Absolutely.
Yeah. But Lisa, one thing people are not talking about, and I'm going to get kicked in my back, but I don't have a problem with that. Our first abusers are our parents. That's domestic violence. Let's follow me here.
Yeah.
Historically,
why do you say
especially
that?
In black homes, but other homes too.
Lisa Durden, who's a pop culture and political commentator. Hi, Lisa. How are you? Hey. When a Carly Fiorina goes on Jimmy Fallon like she did last night, what is the appeal? How do you think it helps her?
what Fiorino did, it wasn't too much and it wasn't too loose and it wasn't unpresidential. I loved it, and she was hilarious. She can't sing, but
yes, the president used the N-word, but white folks, stop. You still better not.
Okay. Being Lisa D. You see, my purpose is for me to speak, and you.